Hello and welcome to our new episode of Amazing China. This is Miao with Xinhua News Agency. And now I'm at the site of world's largest radio telescope, FAST, in a hollow among karst hills in southwest China's Guizhou province. And as you can see, I am standing on the brink of the walkway of the karst. And down there, local authorities are having a ceremony to mark this major scientific breakthrough in China. And down there, you can see there's a triangular reflector panel. This is the sixth last panel of the 4,450 panels for this telescope. And in a second, this one is going to be lifted up and installed into the telescope. And that will mark the construction, the completion of the telescope's construction. For those who have joined our program just now, I will make it one more time. This is the site of the world's largest radio telescope, FAST, or the 500-meter aperture radio telescope.
Thank you.
In answer to your questions earlier, this is the site of world's largest radio telescope, FAST, the 500-meter aperture spherical radio telescope in southwest China's Guizhou province. And the fireworks as part of the ceremony, because today marks the completion of the project's construction. Okay, guys, you can see down there, we have a bunch of people. They're mostly scientists, journalists, engineers, space fans, and local workers, and they are all coming here to celebrate China's major scientific breakthrough, which is the world's largest radio telescope. And the fireworks you just seen, you've seen a few minutes ago, in China, it's kind of a tradition to have fireworks for celebrations, major achievements, weddings. And the Chinese believe that the sound, loud sound of fireworks can bring us best wish and luck. And that's why we're having the ceremony here. And you have to be a little patient. I believe the panel over there is going to be lifted very soon. This is kind of the final piece. And I will explain later when we get onto the telescope a few minutes later. As we're waiting, you can have a general view of this place. I am standing on top of a mountain here, very close to the telescope. And around us, it's actually a karst. It's the karst hills in southwest China's Guizhou. This province is very mountainous. And we have chosen this to be the home of this fantastic project, because here the valley is very, it's quite well shielded from magnetic disruptions, and the ground is stable, so all the conditions are met for this construction of radio telescope. This is going to be a pretty long live broadcast, but I can guarantee you that it's totally worth it. We had a few episodes yesterday to see how the other panel was installed, and we get to go inside, get to the bottom of the telescope. The view is great, and we are going later. And here now, you know, periscope is very sensitive and cannot have any magnetic disruptions. This project is not starting operation yet, so we can still have cell phones and the signals are fine, but in September, when it starts operation, no cell phones, electronics will be allowed, so live shows will be impossible. What you are seeing now is only a part of the telescope structure and the mountains surrounding it. And in a few minutes, we'll see the whole thing, which looks like a giant eye, or someone says it's like a super bowl. It takes quite a long time to lift the panel, so guys, please be patient. Actually, I am standing over 100 meters above the ground, and this telescope is 500 meters in diameter and 138 meters in height. You know what's interesting, just a bit of cute and knowledge here. The first radio antenna for astronomic use, you know, it was built in 1932 by an engineer with Bell Telephone Laboratories. But all the radio signals from the cosmos were so weak that the total energy collected by all radio telescopes worldwide over the past 17 years is barely able to turn a book page. Sana Ulasana, this is a panel of world's largest radio telescope in China, and it's going to be installed in a minute. It's a bit drizzling right now. The climate deep in the mountain is actually very pleasant. Oh, by the way, over there, southwest to the telescope, you might not be able to see right now, but I can explain. Yes, that's the one. This is an observation deck under construction still, but it will be open also in September, and by that time tourists from across the world can come and have a close look at China's radio telescope. Pradip, how long it will take? You mean the panel or the whole project? The panel should be installed in about half an hour, as long as they lift it right away. So this world's largest radio telescope, the project's actually Chinese scientists started looking for a suit place for this project about 12 years ago, and the construction here started only 5 years ago. And down there you can see that panel is a bit transparent. In total, it has 4,450 reflector panels to capture signals from the space. Since it's taking a bit too long, let's get upstairs to see the telescope. Follow me. Okay. This is tricky. Guys, it takes a while and okay, because we are getting upstairs and we have to be careful. Just 1 second, you will see. Okay. A bit of adventure here. Okay, we're about to get inside right away. Okay, so now I'm standing on the walkway of the world's largest radio telescope. It's 138 meters high above ground. And here we are. Let's see. You may want to have a panoramic view here. Gorgeous. What's going on? Okay, let me explain a little bit. So in the middle down there, you can see we have 6 missing parts, right? Missing panels. And 5 of them in the center will not be installed for a while for scientific reasons. And the 6th one is going to be installed today, right away, very soon. And the 6th piece, once it's installed, it marks the completion of the And up there, that is the feed cabin. It's 30 ton and it's used to collect signals from space, and we often compare this whole radio telescope as a giant eye, which makes the feed cabin a retina. And Giglardata, I hope I pronounced correctly, this radio telescope, well, its main scientific mission will be gathering a large amount of new data from a wide range of physical phenomena in the universe. It might be detect radio emissions from extrasolar planets and find traces of aliens from many more stars than in previous research. And it might also explore the origins of the universe. Okay, let me take questions one by one. What would they do with the rainwater? Oh, okay, that's tricky. If you can have a close look, let's find a better angle here to have a close look at the panel, you will see. The panel is very thin. The thickness is only 1 millimeter, and it has thousands of holes on each panel. So rainfall will not be a problem, and plus that the ground here underneath the telescope, the ground is porous enough to drain away rainfalls. We can have a bit of walk here. So this telescope is as large as 30 football grounds, and a walk around it here takes about 40 minutes. So you guys are ready for a walk or no? Maybe we can try. I'm not sure if we have strong signals for life if we go too far, but we can try a little bit. And in front of us, I have seen a few colleagues also doing TV broadcasts. You want to go first? Okay. just for those who have joined our program in a minute. Rana, this is located at a hollow in karst, among karst hills in southwest China's Guizhou province. And yes, this might be the start of alien contact. How far from Shenyang? Shenyang is in northeast China. Phoebe, okay. For those who have just joined our show, let me explain one more time. We are at the site of the world's largest radio telescope, the 500-meter aperture spherical radio telescope, aka FAST. Is it possible to? Okay. So we've got cameras on this narrow walkway, and we're trying to get through. Yesterday, a lot of journalists and scientists and fiction writers have been invited here to take a 40-minute walk around the telescope. Since we are waiting for the panel to be installed, so this giant thing looks like a Super Bowl, and yeah, or giant eye. So I was wondering if this is not used for a radio telescope, what could this one possibly be done with? Maybe you guys have some idea. What would you like to do with this giant bow if it's not a telescope? Yesterday we talked about this, and my colleague says it could be a very nice hot pot, you know. And a bit of in my defense, it's really hard to do live broadcasts here. Signals are not so stable, and we have to climb up a little bit. That's the downside near the periscope. Telescope, sorry. Real about this, everything that's bigger in China, I have to explain that radio telescope for astronomic use, there's no doubt that the bigger is always the better. So as you can see, this one, it measures 500 meters in diameter, and the world's currently operating largest radio telescope, the Arecibo Observatory in Puerto Rico, that one measures 305 meters in diameter. And this one in China, because of the size and also its flexibility, it can observe the sky about 40 degrees in contrast to Arecibo's 20 degrees. As we're still waiting for the installation of the last panel, each panel here in this telescope in China, it is actually flexible, so they can adjust themselves to different directions, and that is a major reason why FAST can have higher sensitivity and more flexibility than Arecibo. Rana Suckling, it takes 5 years to complete the construction, but scientists started 12 years ago for this project. And now, since the construction is done, it takes a few more months for testing and debugging, so this radio telescope will start operation in September. Sangya, why this place? It's surrounded. It's actually at the bottom of a valley. This is all around us. All these are karst hills. And this place was chosen to be the home of the FAST projects because the valley is well sheltered from magnetic disruptions. You know, it's far away from cities, noises, lights, and people. Radio telescope really needs a special place. And also we can have a look at the ground here. Scientists have looked for a lot of places and they decided to choose this one also because the ground here is stable enough to hold the structure and porous enough to drain away rainfalls. In a few minutes, we can get to the bottom underneath of the telescope and have a totally different view as long as the panel is ready. Let's go and have a look at the progress. And looks like we are having the sun coming out. The panel is still down there. Let's see. Okay. Yes, over there. It's going to be lifted by a crane and put to the bottom of the telescope. And we can have a close look at the observation deck over there. Can you see? That is the spot if you come and want to visit. Oh, the receiver, yes, the retina or the feed cabin, the construction is complete. And Richard, this radio telescope is going to be operational in September this year. Although the wait is a bit long, the weather does get better now. It's 10:45 here in China in the morning. I'm sorry this takes so long. I really wanted to show you how the panel is being stored to the telescope. I would love to go to the bottom right now, but I'm afraid that we could miss the installation process. This is pretty hard work, and thousands of workers have contributed their life and energy on this project for years. I think we've got a signal here saying it's going to start. Charles, this radio telescope is composed of 4,450 panels, and this one down there is the sixth last one. And once this one is done, it marks the completion of the project. It starts? Yes. Okay, it's going up. Wow. This triangular panel itself is composed of a lot of smaller triangular panels. Let's move a bit fast to get a close look. It's going up slowly. This place is quite inspirational, I guess, especially for fiction writers. And so the first step is to lift the panels in the sky, and then with a crane it moves slowly from one side to the middle. Today here at the site, only workers, scientists, and journalists have been allowed to get inside. Oh, let's have a look at the drone. We've got a drone here filming the process. Standing down here, I can hear the noises of the drone. The panel is spinning a little bit. We have one worker in blue up there and the other one down. Yes, that is the drone. That's a drone filming the installation of a panel of the world's largest radio telescope in southwest China. Yes, this is a superb project. It costs 1.2 billion Chinese yuan, or 184 million US dollars about, and it is of course China's biggest astronomical project so far. And the panel is moving toward us. Let's see. The crane is started. The crane is it's moving above our head, overhead, and see? Up from here, very close, you can see the panel is very, it's quite transparent because it's thin, it's only 1 millimeter. Comrade, I don't think there is any other large radio telescope in China. And anger, I know, because just along our side, I've seen the CCTV reporters here too. But I think what's better of the show is that we are doing a live and interactive broadcast, which means I can talk to you directly, right? So instead of watching CCTV, stay tuned with us, okay? As the panel is being put down, I've got some rains on my face because we had a drizzle earlier, but now the sky is clear. Thank you, Charles. It's a bit dangerous and I'm a bit scared too. The walkway across the radio telescope is quite narrow, like it's good for two people walking parallel. And yeah, if you look downside, It's very high, over 138 meters above the ground. So again, for newcomers to this program, we are at the construction site of the world's largest radio telescope, the 500-meter aperture spherical radio telescope, aka FAST. I really like the name, FAST. I would very much like to show you the whole picture, but this is the only spot where we are allowed to stand, and this is the best view we can get now. And we're about to see the panel going down to the bottom of the telescope. We've got a bit of sunshine reflecting. I'm pretty sure that we are the only ones here doing live on Facebook. The panel is going down slowly. The ropes, you can see water going down from the ropes. Water rainfalls completely, it doesn't matter to the project. Okay, we've got a little platform here and one more photojournalist here, and at this spot, it's the best spot here. We are going to see how this panel is installed to the final spot apart from the five pieces. As you guys are watching, let me explain a background again. So the 500-meter aperture spherical radio telescope is the world's largest when it starts operation in September. It has a diameter of 500 meters and a height of over 138 meters. And the 30-ton feet cabin suspended over there in the air, that one is responsible for collecting signals from the universe. While the gigantic spherical reflector, which is made up of 4,450 triangular panels, this is the whole dish is used to capture signals, and each of the pieces can adjust themselves. And what you're looking at up there is simply one of the 4,450 panels. And there it is. The drone is here now. I suppose the drone driver has to be really careful. David Rowe. Yes, I agree. It's used in a James Bond movie. It looks quite familiar. SM Lee, that is not actually my concern. As a journalist, what I'm working for is to do the best and show you what's happening here in China. And Rana Sackling, yes, I hope so. Hope someday this world's largest radio telescope is going to help us find aliens. And down there, this is the best we can do with the phone camera, but you can see a few people are already waiting at the bottom. Bernard, if you're asking about me, I'm a journalist with China State Media Xinhua News Agency. So this world's largest radio telescope, its main scientific mission would be gathering a large amount of new data from a wide range of physical phenomena in the universe. It might be able to detect radio emissions from extrasolar planets and search for traces of aliens, ETs, around many more stars than in previous research, and it might explore the origins of the universe. I know this panel installation takes quite a long time, but this is something you will not see elsewhere. Thank you, Chris Nato. Really appreciate that. For those newcomers, this is the panel being installed into the world's largest radio telescope, located at a hollow among karst hills in southwest China's Guizhou province. Guizhou province is famous in China. It's famous for karst landscape. Also diverse ethnic culture, pleasant climate, and very delicious local food, actually. What you are seeing in the camera, yes, this panel is going to be put down there in its spot. You see six pieces are missing, and this one is going to fill one of the blanks. In Rafik, my name is Miao, surname is Miao, and sounds like a cat, I know. Let's have a look at the walkway here. You see we have two journalists over there. We have two photo guys here. And we have two journalists there. So all together, I think fewer than 10 people are able to watch this live. And I'm sharing this on Facebook so that you can watch it as we do. From this angle, the panel is huge enough, but once it's put down there, it's going to be tiny. You see? Because altogether we have 4,450 panels for this radio telescope. And you know, in astronomical studies, we have two kinds of telescopes, the radio one and the optical one, and both have been helping scientists to do astronomical research and explore the universe. I'm not sure why it takes so long to put it down. Thank you, Crescento. And Comrade, yes, 1.2 billion yuan or $184 million for this colossal project. In Songjia, what's happening today? So today marks the completion of the project, the construction project of the radio telescope. Yes, it takes a few more months before it starts operation in September, but the final panel being installed also is kind of a very exciting moment for Chinese people here. I'm from China and I am in southwest China's Guizhou province. Oh, it's moving. Okay. I thought it was going down. Looks like it's the job of the wind. Guys, thank you so much for the patience. Like in a few months, if you come here and want to visit the world's largest radio telescope, and also in answer to your question, Ayan Sahu. So if you want to come and visit China, and specifically if you are an astronomical fan and you want to come here and see the radio telescope, once it starts operation, no cell phones, electronics, or even cars will be allowed inside within a radius of 5 kilometers, because all these things could be disruptive, you know, have a lot of magnetic disruptions to the operation of the telescope. So if you decide to come here, you will have to accept the fact that you will be completely disconnected from the outside world. It can be quite a good thing if you want to, you know, have some me time. Doris Regilio, I do not understand your question. How to have this? Oh, Ali, I like your comments. Want to write cycle on it? Me too. But you can't, yes. not only because this is a radio telescope that you can't ride a bike on it, but also the panels are only 1 millimeter in thickness. And the chief scientist of this project said earlier that once it starts operation, this will be the best of the world's telescopes in 20 or 30 years. I'm sorry if the camera shakes sometime. It's been quite a long time, and we only have a cell phone at hand. Watch it. It's actually the completion of a giant construction project. If you can afford it, it's 1.2 billion Chinese yuan, or 184 million Chinese US dollars. With this world's largest radio telescope, scientists not only from China but also from other nations will be able to explore deeper into the space and hopefully find traces of aliens. Ali, I think bird is a problem and scientists are taking care of this problem. As you can see, so far we haven't seen a bird yet. To find a good spot to take care of the triple. Mm-hmm. Okay, it's good. And Waji, in answer to your question, this is Miao with Xinhua News Agency, and I'm reporting at the site of world's largest radio telescope, FAST. And scientists and engineers are installing the final panel, which will mark the completion of the construction projects. Hope that answers. Okay, let's get back to the telescope. This is probably the longest live broadcast I've been doing so far. We were not told earlier about how long this could take, but you know, science, and it takes as long as it needs, right? Oh, thank you, Akif. I like my hat too. It's the security, the safety one, in case of accidents or stones falling. Okay, I'm sorry for the noises just now. A few of my colleagues and others are very curious about what I'm doing right now, holding a giant microphone. I've learned the lesson that anything can happen during live broadcasts. Christiana Liu, it's not hot. The temperature is perfect. It's a great day in the summer. Here in Guizhou province, it kind of has the fame that the climate is perfect here. It's not too cold in the winter. It's quite cold, but not that cold. And in the summer, it's very cool and pleasant. Akif, this is the, if you're asking about the telescope, this is the world's largest radio telescope, and it's to be used for astronomic research for scientists. And if you're asking about the panel is one of the 4,450 pieces of the reflector dish for this telescope. And Ali, what is your question again? I'm sorry, I cannot keep looking at the screen all the time. Sometimes I have to look elsewhere. And Sibu, we scientists hope that we can search for traces of aliens with this radio telescope. And I know it's a dream of many people, ordinary ones, that someday we can communicate, talk with perhaps an alien, right? I'm also curious for this, we're watching our program, what could possibly be the first sentence you'd like to say to an alien if you you're lucky enough to come across one? Could you guys share? For me, I would probably say hello, ni hao, buongiorno. I will try every language that I know that says hello. No, I'm just joking. So guys, Ronald King, to make this radio telescope, the construction takes 5 years. The whole project from the beginning with the first intention until now, it takes already 12 years. And for this panel to be installed, I guess at least 1 hour. And we are halfway there. And what you're looking right now, this radio telescope is 500 meters in diameter. And you know, when it comes to radio telescope, there's no doubt that the bigger is the better. We don't really know what's going on right now. People just are waiting. Rafik, I think Chinese scientists, and if in collaboration with scientists from other countries, they can all control and collect data from this radio telescope. Akif, yes, down there at the bottom, there are quite a lot of people waiting for this panel. Guys, would you like to go downside? I'm not sure when this is going to come down. I cannot guarantee, but we have a shot if we go now, take the car, and drive all the way to the bottom. Rafael, this is located at a hollow in southwest China's Guizhou in the scenic mountains. Rafik, scientists will control this radio telescope. I believe a lot of them are surely from China, but scientists from other countries will be welcomed. Would you like to go now? We can go and take the car and see if we can drive all the way to the bottom. It's a bit risky. Probably we could lose signals on the way, but I will try, okay? So follow me. Okay, guys, I'm taking a few steps down. It's gonna be a while. Okay. Okay, just wait a second, I have to talk to the driver. Okay. Oh, okay. Another car. Okay. We have a car waiting for us. It's a bit of rocky road here, and the fastest way to get to the bottom is to drive a car. And the views on the way, it's fabulous. I've done it yesterday. This is that would be my best part. It's even more amazing than looking from the upper side. Seeing my driver. Okay, let me okay. You ready? It's gonna be a fabulous trip. My colleagues are getting in too, so it takes just a minute.
Okay.
Okay. And here we go. And this is the bottom of the telescope on the way as we drive. You know, the like image quality of the cell phone is not as good as a camera, but doing live with a cell phone means that it can move fast and can make you feel like you are in the car too. Driving around the world's largest radio telescope. I am putting my hand outside of the car's window. Hope you are having a good shot. We have seen so many people here observing the process of the installation of the panel. Hey guys, want to say hi?
Hey y'all.
Okay, now you can see Okay, so guys, we have to stay here for 1 second because I just spotted that the panel is going down to the bottom. So let me get outside of the car and we have a look and then we go downside, okay? Okay, this is too far away. Let's get back to the car and we can catch up with the people celebrating downstairs. Mike, this is the world's largest radio telescope in southwest China's Guizhou, and we are on a car driving around it to get from the top to the bottom. Radio telescope, right? And this is near the bottom of it. kind of the inside view. The project costs 1.2 billion Chinese yuan, or 184 million US dollars. And we are driving all the way down. Well, I get my driver. It's bumpy, right? And you see over there, in the middle, it's the big cabin that is used to collect signals from the universe. And the panel is about to reach the bottom soon. We're getting there, okay? Workers who have been working here were sometimes compared as Spider-Man because the work is really hard. I'm putting the camera in the front of the car so that it might make you feel like you were sitting at my spot. That's the view you will get. Johnny, if I remember correctly, the panels are made of a few kinds of steels and other metals. Bottom of the world's largest radio telescope. It's called FAST. It's too hard for me, but my driver, yes. A few minutes ago, we were watching from the top, and now we're about to get to the bottom. Okay. Long way, but we're getting here. A lot of people are at the bottom already. Okay, guys, now we are at the bottom of world's largest radio telescope, and let's get inside quickly. Oh, I have seen balloons here. Okay, so we have a celebration, I guess. Wow. So, wow. We are here right on time, right? Okay, guys, this is Miao with Xinhua News Agency, and I at the bottom of the world's largest radio telescope, and they are installing one panel, and that panel, once it's completed, it will mark the completion of the whole construction project. And you can see the panel is going down slowly, and it's going to fill the spotlights. Let's have a close look. Follow me. So this part is the spot for this panel. The worker is using a hook to get it to the right spot. Awesome. Red banner. Comrade, the banners here is just the red flag of the construction company. It's the Chinese characters on the flag are the names of the company. If you said that at the very beginning, we have been waiting for so long, but now this is quite a moment, right? It's magnificent and kind of historical. And here at the bottom, you can see mostly journalists and scientists here. And you can see over there, we have, I think it's from National Broadcaster, and he's doing interviews and also live broadcast. But I personally think ours is better because it's always interactive and I can always talk to you and answer your questions. And we can move freely. Wajid, the name of the company is called Wu Chuan. I'm not sure if you understand. If translated separately, it has an English name on it. It's called CSIC. If translated separately, the first character Wu means martial arts, and second one means boats. We can have a close look at the red flag if you want. Yeah. Okay. And our panel is going to fill the spot. See closely how the workers here managed to dot all this panel with the others surrounding it. They are adjusting the positions to put the panel down. This is really the finishing touch of the construction of the world's largest radio telescope's main body in southwest China's Guizhou province. This project, the world's largest radio telescope, which started about 12 years ago and whose construction started 5 years ago, really puts China at the forefront of radio telescope-based space research. And when it starts operation in September, it will allow scientists to explore deeper into the space, and it will be open to scientists from China and other nations. We are doing this live broadcast on Facebook because once this radio telescope starts operation, it will be impossible to use a phone or have a live show here because all signals will be disruptive and not loud. Oh, wow! So as the panel is installed, we have all those colorful balloons as part of the celebration. So guys, this is the moment when China completes the construction of its largest radio telescope. Thank you, Christina. Okay, so guys, you know, chief scientist of this project said earlier that once this world's largest radio telescope starts operation, it will remain the best in the world in the next 20 or 30 years. And this telescope will not answer questions related to astronomy, but also about humanity and nature. And let's have a grand view from the bottom. We are standing at the center of the bottom of the world's largest radio telescope. This is the view from bottom. Thank you. Let me see if we can talk to any of the workers here. Okay.
那个梁先生您好，可不可以我是新华社的记者，可不可以简单采访一下您？我们在做电视直播，可以吗？
So
guys, I've located two workers who have contributed to this project, and let's see how they feel about the completion.
您说一下您在这里工作多久，是哪里人？
我是北京启动运输建设计研究院，我主要负责这个吊装设备的总体设计。因为今年我们圆满地完成了 FAST 的反射面单元的吊装工作，作为我们内心来说，我们也很高兴。这是从刚开始干这个项目到今天全部完成，是很兴奋，也很高兴的事情。
等一下 ，So guys, turns out he's one of the main engineers behind this project, and he is the designer. He's a designer of all the panels we have just seen, the 4,450 panels which are used as reflector to capture signals from the universe. And as today marks the completion of the construction, this engineer is more than proud and happy.
还有没有其他有没有能不能跟我们分享一下在这个过程中的感受？
这个过程之中是很艰辛，因为这个进行了很多技术创新。第一，这个甲方天文台给我们的要求是，这个工程要100%的成功，100%就是不是99.9%，它是没有那个0.00几。这是第一。第二，一定要我们做这个工程的时候有极大的技术创新，这个技术创新体现在我们吊装设备的各个方面，可能今天大家都看见了。
So he said, in brief, there are so many innovations in this project, from design to construction, everything. It's very hard and it's a lot of work. And he said, the whole team wants this one to be 100% success, not even 99.90% success. That's not good enough. This one has to be 100% success. Okay.
第二就是我们那个有极大的技术创新，今天大伙都看见了。虽然我们这样很顺利的，但是这个里面是建立在我们丰富的技术创新和强大的技术团队的这个基础之上的，才是有今天很圆满的。
So what we are seeing now is a very smooth success of the completion of the project. But behind that, a lot of workers have made so many efforts to make this happen.
因为为我们国家的大科学工程做出我们自己应有的贡献，是我们作为一个普通的工程技术人员应尽的一个职责。国家天文台给我们提供这么大好一个项目工程，给我们提供这一个舞台，把我们充分展现自己的一个技术能力，这也体现了一个国家的一个综合实力。
So as an ordinary engineer in China, I'm very proud that I can contribute to this national projects, and I'm grateful that and with this magnificent platform of building this projects, I'm happy that I'm contributing.
因为我们国家的重点工程做出一点贡献是我们应尽的义务，所以说为我们国家的强大我们也感到非常的高兴和自豪。谢谢。
I feel responsible that I have to contribute to the national projects, and I'm very proud for this project. Okay.
谢谢。
我再说一下，就是现在在电视机前，不是在我们手机前面，有很多外国人在看这个节目。有没有什么话想跟外国的朋友说？有没有想邀请他们来看一看？
就是我们这个大科学工程今年9月份就要竣工了，希望很多全世界的天文爱好者或天文工作者或天文就是一些旅游爱好者，到 FAST 的这个现场来目睹这个 FAST 的宏伟的那个风姿，也看看我们国家大科学工程是如何的，就是的那个什么宏伟壮大。同时，因为看看我们这个科学工作者是如何把我们这个大科学工程从一点一滴变成现在的现实的。
I just asked our engineer that if he wants to say something to our audience, to all you guys, and he said, I would like to invite you all to come and to visit our the world's largest radio telescope in Guizhou, and because this one will be the door will be open to all scientists, all astronomic fans and tourists from all the other countries. So guys, please come. And as he record the whole process, he's getting a bit emotional. I can see he feels like it's so much work, and he's very he's quite into it.
谢谢啊，欢迎大家到中国来，到平昌来。
So welcome to China and to Pingtang Town, which is the home of this telescope. Okay.
谢谢。
Okay. Guys, I hope this guy is really nice and he's very excited. I can see he tries to hold the emotion, but I can still feel it. Okay. So let's have a bit more here. And just to say, we've talked with a few scientists earlier about this potential, and they all said the potential of this world's largest radio telescope is huge, and it's still too early to predict. It has to wait until it starts operation. Those people here, like most workers here, they're local and they're not quite used to talking with people outsiders and quite shy actually. And our engineers just took a group photo. This is a big day for them, I guess. I suppose after the program is done, it's photo time, selfie time, right? Maybe we can go climb the stairs and have a better view. Okay, just noticed. Let's see. Now we are standing at the Guys, okay, we lost signal for a while when we tried to get upside here, so let's go back to this place because it has a better view. I was really worried that we could lose the signal right away, Looks like we're lucky and it's back. So let's have a 360 degree panoramic view of the world's largest radio telescope, okay? Okay, and down here we can see our engineers, workers are taking interviews from journalists. I can overhear even from here, and he said there's not even a bit of problem in today's installation process. And we have got the sun out. It only makes this colossal project even more magnificent. Okay guys, this is Miao with Xinhua News Agency, and I'm standing on a platform at the bottom of the world's largest radio telescope. And just now, with the installation of the panel into the large dish that captures signals from the universe, it marks the completion of the world's largest radio telescope's constructions. The main body is done, and in September, it will start operation, and it will be open to scientists from across the world and also to tourists. And as I said earlier, Chinese scientists have said this potential for this project is still huge and hard to predict. Actually, China has been quite ambitious in space programs. Apart from this fast project, China also wants to send an astronaut to the moon and build a space station into orbit. So hopefully someday we can have a live broadcast on the moon or in space station. That's all for today, and thank you guys for your participation and your patience. Really appreciate it. Bye-bye for now. See you soon. Bye-bye.